Hello friends, I hope you're having a lovely day. As you all know, AI is now everywhere and we can't run from it. But we can try to stay informed about new tools, about new possibilities and learn how to use them so we can benefit from them. If you are an enthusiast of AI art for private or commercial purposes, I got a nice new tool that I want to show you today. I just found out about this new interesting AI tool from NVIDIA that is totally free but unfortunately only for Windows system. The name of this application, NVIDIA Canvas. And with this, you can literally draw like a 3-year-old child and still get beautiful photorealistic landscapes. You can also create normal size, the standard size picture for the software, or panorama size, which is still a beta version, but still you can do it, and you can use the panorama to create a 3D view of that image, of that background, and for example, use in your applications and even games. So let me show you what I mean. To get NVIDIA Canvas, you can just go to this website. I'm gonna leave the link down below in the description, by the way. Just click download beta and download it, install it, and run it. Now you can see a few options, the standard and the panorama, which is a beta version. As I mentioned, we are gonna start with the standard. I just wanna show you how it works. Let's press continue. So you will start with this canvas with a different sky, and you have different materials here on top, like sky, cloud, hill, mountains, water, forest, and so on and so forth. We start with this canvas that is completely blue, that meaning that it has this sky over here. So if I have my pencil selected, doesn't matter the size of my pencil, you can see it doesn't paint anything because that's the sky, that's the first material. So now we want to add some more information there. And then we can play around with different styles and everything. We have layers that we can add and you can also rename them. So the first one, the default layer, I'm gonna name is sky, enter. And now let's add some grass. So here we have the option of using this pencil, which is round, or to create lines. And there you see you have a patch of grass in the middle of the sky. So let me get this back. I'm gonna use the line just to make like a stretch of grass here. Ah, now it looks better, it's not floating. And you can see that it adds the grass on the bottom. And I can make it bigger and bigger as much as I wanted to take from this picture. Now I'm gonna change to pencil. And let's add some flowers. Let's add flowers everywhere. River. That was supposed to be a line as well, but yeah, that's how it is. It's hard to draw with the mouse, right? This looks like the sea, so I need to put some more grass on the other side. And here we go. This will be a river. Now it is a river. Perfect. Let's put some stone wall in another layer. Over here, put, I don't know, like a path to the river. Very nice, beautiful. Make another layer and add some trees on the background. Woo, there we go, we have our tree. That's some interesting trees, there you go. And we can make some trees also somewhere there, very small. Difficult to see, but it's good. Beautiful, beautiful sunset. I'm gonna start with the hill. Let's add a new layer and paint some hills over here. Boop, 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 boop. There you go. The layers on the top are what appear first on the scene, and the ones that are below are the ones in the background. So background and foreground. Great. I think the sky is a bit too empty, so let's add as well some clouds, like a heart-shaped cloud. I don't know if that's gonna work. I mean, it doesn't even look like a heart. There you go! Yay! Beautiful. And what you can try is also to use different variations, so you can use like the slider to look at different landscapes. There you go, there are different styles. You can go for snowy, you can go for summer. So if you like this picture, you can just go up here. There is a save file option. Gonna save as a can file. Toolbar here, you can move wherever you want. So for example, here would be easier actually in the middle, because you can select something, just change or erase whatever you want, or change the size and then just paint, because if it's on this side, you have to go from the right to the left to the middle. Here you can change the view if you want to see only your drawing, if you want to see both of them, or just the result. So if you want to export as a PNG, you select the export button. Now let's go and try a panorama picture. Panorama. Here we have the panorama and we have the same materials, and here on top you also can see the 3D preview. So as I mentioned, if you decide to use this in your game, if you're developing a game for example, or a VR environment, you can already preview how it's gonna look like. So let's put some information here, shall we? Okay, mountain coming, and a new layer and add water. Let's make some water flowing from this mountain. Let's add some bushes. And then some trees. We want trees everywhere. Trees are nice. Trees are cute. And, oh, actually, we could make like a path, right? We can make a path going through the woods. Mud. Oh, it's rendering already. Okay, just a second. I'm not done. Oh, there is the big mountain over there. Look, here is my path of dirt in the middle of the forest. And here we have our water coming from the sky. I want mountains. I am an artist. This is terrible. I created new results. I used that same image that I created first. I used as an input in Midjourney and asked for new styles. For example, in this first case, I created pixel style, pixel art, and this is what I got from Midjourney version 4. And I also asked for sketches. And the sketches are a bit different, I found, a bit different from what the original images were, but I just wanted to experiment. But it works probably as well with Blue Willow. Actually, I asked Blue Willow for something, and I used as an input in Blue Willow and just asked for an illustration, and this is what I got. In any case, that's it. I really wanted to show you guys this, and I hope you find it useful. I hope you practice more than I did. And yeah, I hope you guys liked it. Please like this video if you enjoy it. I see you guys in the next one. Bye!